Hey there, could I interest you in some chocolate?
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 Did you say chocolate? Chocolate?
I understand. You want to know what makes chocolate so great.
Chocolate! Chocolate!
But is chocolate actually so great?
Chocolate!
Or will it? I don't think chocolate needs that much of an introduction. We all know what it is, but what is the deal with this centuries-old product? Is it healthy or not? And should we eat more of it or less? Hey, I'm a fourth-year nutrition student from the Netherlands, and in this video I'm going to tell you everything you need to know and want to know about chocolate. I'm not going to lie, you might feel slightly sad after this video. There's no but. To find out what you wanted to know about chocolate, I went to the greatest internet browser.
Not Google.
And
not Google.
Gave me this. I immediately noticed that people were more concerned about animals' well-being than that of themselves. Good. So, to make this video complete, I will also answer the first questions. Let's see, what do we got here? Is chocolate vegan? Well, that depends. Usually dark chocolate is, but you gotta check the back to make sure. Is chocolate bad for cats? Don't give chocolate to cats. They don't even like it. The symptoms are death. Is chocolate bad for dogs? Symptoms are death. Is chocolate candy? Next. Is chocolate healthy? Ah, now we're getting somewhere. So, to understand this better, we're going to go over the when, the what, and the where. Well, actually not the where, but the how much, but I really wanted the third W because it sounded cooler. Of chocolate. Firstly, when. I found this interesting article in the Harvard Gazette from the Division of Sleep and Circadian Disorders, Department of Medicine and Neurology at Harvard-affiliated Brigham and Women's Hospital, published a research study about when the best time is to eat chocolate. The title right off the bat is a bit misleading because when I looked further into the article, it shows that there was no significant weight loss at all. Scam. Not completely, because what they did find was that waist circumference did go down and fat burning did go up. And waist circumference is a major indicator of someone's health, because too big indicates excess visceral fat, and visceral fat is the fat that sits around your organs. And if there's too much fat around your organs, they can't really do their work properly. Weight, on the other hand, is not a good indicator of someone's health, because, for example, muscle is a lot heavier than fat is. And if you step on the scale and you see your weight has dropped, you do not know if it was muscle or if it was fat. You definitely don't want it to be muscle. So what did they find? When should we eat chocolate? In the morning? Afternoon snack? In the middle of the night? As we can see here, the appetite for sweets and other energy intake lowered for both groups. Physical activity went up for the evening eaters. However, fat burning only went up for morning eaters, and this might explain why their waist circumference went down. There was also a lowering of certain gut bacteria, the ones that were related to diabetes and obesity. This was present with both the morning as the evening eaters. But the ones in the morning had a greater reduction, and the good bacteria were thriving. Interesting to note is that apparently people also fell asleep earlier, because the nap frequency for the morning eaters rose and normal sleep for the evening eaters. So chocolate makes you fall asleep? All things considered, I would say morning is best, but evening eaters also get some points. Do have to mention though, this research was done on menopausal women of at least 55 years old. Was also not a very big study, with just 19 people partaking from start to finish. So to say that this applies to everyone, it's hard to say. But if you're gonna eat chocolate anyways, why not give it a go in the morning and tell me if you notice any differences. The chocolate used in this research was milk chocolate. This chocolate contains more carbs, less fiber, and overall less of the cacao bean. Were this study done on dark chocolate, the results may have been very different, as cacao contains an amount of caffeine, which makes you more alert. And carbohydrates in the refined form, known as sugar, will make you crash and burn easier. So my theory theory would be that dark chocolate actually doesn't make you as sleepy, and that the protein in the dark chocolate will make you more satisfied. Though that's just what I think. And now for a seamless transition into the next part. What? As in, what chocolate should you consume? You might have heard somewhere that dark chocolate is the essence of life and the only reason that the queen is still alive. What exactly makes dark chocolate so special? Why would dark chocolate be a better choice for you over milk or even white chocolate?
But what about crisps? And nuts? And you have caramel and there's—
Whoa there, one thing at a time. Okay, so to define chocolate, if it's healthy or not healthy, you first need to know what exactly is in chocolate. I took it upon myself to divide the chocolate bar into these ingredients. Let's go over all of them. Cacao butter and cacao powder are main ingredients into calling something chocolate. So let's start off there. Cacao powder has been highly praised for its health benefits dating back to the time of the Mayans. This is because of the many active ingredients within cacao powder. Studies have shown that it can help prevent coronary heart disease, it can lower cholesterol, it can help with muscle soreness, and it can even lessen the symptoms of depression by helping improve someone's mood. Cacao powder also contains a lot of vitamins and minerals, like iron and selenium. This makes chocolate a good snack if you're feeling tired because of an iron deficiency. Lastly, it is incredibly high in protein, making it a good recovery supplement when you just had a workout. I personally also found it effective if you have a stubborn eye twitch. Though, if you are experiencing these symptoms for longer periods of time or very frequent, I think it'd be good if you, like, see a physician. Now for cacao butter, the fat of the cacao bean. And the only reason why white chocolate is still considered chocolate, even though it doesn't look like it at all. Cacao butter is a saturated fat. You know something is a saturated fat by its composition in room temperature. And there's actually a lot of debate going on about the subject. Heating saturated fat, however, has been shown to be better than heating unsaturated fat. Saturated fats are more stable and unsaturated fats can turn into trans fats. And those are bad. But we're getting off topic here. I tried to find some studies written specifically about cacao butter, and this is what I found. This 2014 animal study showed that the bioavailability of cacao butter is poor, so its absorption is weak compared to other oils. Oleic acid has beneficial effects on the lipid levels, and the absorption of cholesterol was lower with cacao butter than that of corn oil. They concluded that cacao butter, although saturated, did not raise cholesterol and did instead only have positive effects. They think this has something to do with the other healthy components that are derived from the cacao bean that inhibit the cacao butter. And this other mice study showed that saturated fat may indeed lead to cardiac arrest. However, cacao butter doesn't seem to be one of them. So allegedly, cacao butter should be fine to consume and should even have potential health benefits. But these were just animal studies. I did try to find some human studies done on the subject, but they were harder to find, especially the recent ones. So what about the other fats in chocolate? Chocolate doesn't need any other fats, but...
What? Profits down $3 from last month!
Cacao butter is pretty pricey. Companies usually use other fats and oils to keep their spendings down. The most popular one used is palm oil. You also find palm oil in basically any other processed good because it is so cheap. But is it healthy? It has been shown to have both health benefits as health risks. They do seem to be sure though that fresh palm oil is better than heated palm oil, and that palm oil should not be reheated. And what is reheated again? Alright, chocolate is. So maybe we can say that palm oil in chocolate is not healthy for you after all. Another trick that manufacturers use to cut out of the high cost of cacao butter is by using lecithin. This food additive is a kind of fat called a phospholipid. You see, usually derived from soy, but it can also be derived from other plants as well as animal sources. As for the research of lecithin, I have read some debate about this. Some people claim that it is lecithin that will make them feel unwell after consuming chocolate, while lecithin-free chocolate will not. However, this is anecdotal evidence at best, and I did not find any studies that have been performed to prove this. But vice versa, even though lecithin has been said to be safe for consuming for the general population, it does not mean that's the case for everyone. If you experience any rashes or feel unwell after consuming chocolate with lecithin in it, you might want to mention this to your physician. Lecithin by itself is also used in other products and is supposedly be able to relieve certain pains, but the evidence here is lacking as well. So would I say this ingredient is healthy? Well, the evidence out there simply points to it being safe, so I wouldn't go out of my way to say it's healthy. Next potential ingredient on the list is milk. Obviously, milk is usually found in milk chocolates or white chocolate. Real dark chocolate doesn't contain any milk. Milk is an incredibly controversial topic ever since the vegan movement has been on the rise, but let's keep it strictly within the borders of health. Is it any good in your chocolate? About 75% of the world is intolerant for the sugar in milk, lactose. Making milk, not such a good idea for these people. But let's say you consume milk products all of the time, and you don't experience any of the lactose intolerance problems like digestive issues, skin issues, bloating, nausea. Is the milk healthy for you? So I looked at milk, and I saw a lot of positive reviews. But then I looked a bit closer and I saw that it was all about human milk, and I don't think we have human milk in chocolate, at least not yet, so I had to specify to cow milk. Milk, a rich source of vitamins, minerals, amino acids, and it has been said to improve bone structure, therefore making it healthy for children as well as adults.
That's it, Patrick! We've gotta stretch the truth!
Chocolate!
However, I found numerous articles that study this principle that have shown the exact opposite. Instead of improving bone health, risk of fractures as well as mortality has been shown to increase with regular milk consumption. This may be due to the inflammatory properties of dairy or the lower absorption rate of vitamin D and calcium than it was initially thought to be the case. And lactose also seems to be a problem for lactose tolerant people, as it can be indirectly linked to coronary heart diseases and therefore cardiac arrest. So yeah, milk doesn't seem to make the chocolate bar a lot healthier. Moving on to sugar. It's our favorite carb, also known as glucose or table sugar. You can also find other sugars like fructose or glucose with different names like these. It's a lot. They do this because we know that the first ingredient on the ingredient list is what the product contains most of, and we don't want to see sugar as the main ingredient now, do we? So they divide it. Sneaky. People that look at their ingredients in the first place are aware that sugar is not that healthy. But why? Sugar on its own doesn't contain any other nutrients but energy. Together with that, it has been linked to the aging of cells, several chronic diseases, a lowered immune system, poor gut health, and therefore also a lowered absorption of nutrients, acne, and there's just a lot. Sugar is a complicated subject, and although most can agree that it is bad for you, it isn't that simple. I'd like to further explain in a future video. But for now, just remember that if sugar is added, then it is likely not to be that beneficial for your health. However, if it's naturally in the food, like for fruits, then you shouldn't worry too much. So even though the cacao bean grows from a tree, chocolate bars do not. So I would say less sugar is better. But that's good news if you like dark chocolate. Last ingredient on the list, the extras. I didn't really know what to call this, so I'm just gonna go with extras. I'm talking nuts, crisps, air,
water,
caramel,
earth, fire, air. Long ago.
Wait, firstly caramel. Oh, that's basically just sugar. We just covered that. Then crisps. Well, it depends. What kind of crisps? They are usually popped grains like corn or rice, containing a little bit of fiber, a little bit of protein, some nutrients, but it's usually an insignificant amount and it doesn't really help you, but it doesn't do any harm either. So I would say the more is better, but make sure that it doesn't contain more sugar, because it usually does when you add these. Then these nuts, nice choice. Omega-3s, vitamin E, fiber, minerals like zinc, there's a lot that can be found in nuts. So I would say more is better for this one as well. Though eating a sugar-filled chocolate bar just to meet your requirements on these nutrients, maybe not the best idea. So to answer your question in what kind of chocolate you should consume, make it as milk and sugar-free as possible and go for nuts, crisps, if you can. But I think the most boring option would just be to go for the regular dark chocolate and actual dark chocolate, which is above 80%. And now last but not least, the third W, how much? This kind of depends on you. If you're a sugar addict and would otherwise eat sweets without chocolate, then do replace them with chocolate or fruits, vegetables. However, if you already eat a balanced diet and like to include chocolate, then I would say a few pieces of dark chocolate should do the trick. And if the dark chocolate is too bitter for you, try including them into foods you're already eating, like cereal or peanut butter sandwich. Although much evidence exists on chocolate being healthy for you, we should, like with everything, not overindulge. Add it to a balanced diet, 30 grams of dark chocolate has been shown to be good, thanks to purely the magic of the cacao bean. Well, not magic, but science.
Chocolate. I remember when they first invented chocolate.
Actually, don't really like chocolate that much.
Sweet, sweet chocolate.
But I'll eat it just so I can flex that I'm immortal.
I always hated it.